about her question, her answer for my question is that he just listened to him or her very carefully, very intensively to solve the trouble. Okay, now today's title is To Eat Less, Imagine Eating Any Food.
Good evening, Yoido Toastmasters.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Welcome. Great speaker. Every day, do you wanna eat less food for your diet?
Try.
Me too. Then, how can we eat less food every day? To eat less, do you think we have to suppress the desire we want to eat food? No, don't suppress the desire you want to eat food. Why not? Because studies said, more and more we suppress the desire, we will eat more and more food. So instead of suppressing the desire you want to eat food, eat any food you'd like to eat in your imagination. For example, if you'd like to eat chicken and draft beer, chime,
right,
just look at the image. You are eating them a lot in your imagination. With any food, you can do like this. According to new research from Carnegie Mellon University, it was found that imagine eating food makes us eat less. There are two their research results. First, if we imagine eating food vividly with all our five senses, dopamine, a neurotransmitter, releases from our brain. It is related to pleasure and satiety. So more and more we imagine eating food, more and more dopamine releases from our brain. Then we'll get sick and tired of the food and feel full. And then finally, we will eat less. Second, our brain does not distinguish between reality and imagination. So while we are imagining eating food, our brain acts as if we are eating the food in reality. So naturally, it leads us to eat less. Did you read the book titled Watching?
Watching?
No?
No.
This book says that there was one woman who was worrying about her weight. Because even though her height was only 160 centimeters, her weight was almost 65 kilograms. But she started to only imagine eating any food she'd like to eat in her imagination, instead of eating food a lot like a horse in reality. It made her get sick and tired of the food and fearful and eat less. So finally, she lost weight a lot and became very thin. I brought one apple for you. Now I give you one chance. You can enjoy eating this apple very vividly. Deliciously, in your imagination. Would you like to do that now?
Yeah.
Good. Now, close your eyes, please. I hope you see and hear this apple very vividly with all your five senses. Okay? Now, in your imagination, first, touch this apple with your hand. And then and smell it with your nose. Touch and smell it, please. How do you feel? How is the smell?
Fresh.
You smell or sweet smell? Good. Next, now get one bite of the apple with your teeth and then chew, please. Continually chew, please. How do you feel? What is the taste? Sweet, delicious, and sour. Good. Continually chew, please. Now, swallow it with your saliva. Open your eyes, please. Did you feel it very vividly like reality?
I tried.
Thanks for joining in my trying. Like this, our brain does not distinguish between reality and imagination. So with any food, you can do like this. To eat less, from now on, what do you do? Instead of suppressing the desire you want to eat food, just imagine eating any food you'd like to eat very vividly with all your five senses. In your imagination, like well. Thank you.
Thank you.
It was like hypnosis.